Yo, what's up, guys, and welcome back to the next episode of the VGC Road to Rank. Today is the final episode with this team from my boy Abe. I actually just had started recording it, and then I found out I lost the game because my hidden power on Jerkatry was steel and not grounds. I was really sad. I saw that. Maybe I'll put that out as like a blooper recording, but I didn't feel like finishing recording that. So this should be HP ground Jerkatry, hopefully. I'm hoping. But in any case, if you guys are enjoying the VGC World event, feel free to check out the playlist if you want to see the rest of it, as well as follow me on Twitch and Twitter. We are learning, my friends. We are learning. Doing our best. This is the last episode with this team. So in tomorrow's episode, you guys will have Face Cam and a new team. I also plan on having a few more friends on shortly. I think Wolf is busy, unfortunately. But I have a few other friends that I want to bring on. So I don't know, like this type of team, I'm still having trouble figuring out what to lead. I know Dragonite plus partner is usually good with something in the back to do with it, but like, I'm not sure. The other time I crit myself with Bulldoze is actually pretty funny, but ideally we get two wins today. We can end it on a positive note with this squad before switching over. And I'm trying to watch other people play as well, because that's the best way to learn. But I think the thing I struggle most with is, again, just picking a good or best lead. That's a lead that matches up well versus what they have and gives me enough in the back to deal with that. Also, you know, my I'm not super familiar with certain things. Like, for example, this is pseudo Trick Room. If he brings Gyarados, he definitely has Marowak. So, I think Dragonite Zerkatry is a great lead. I can Tail Glow, like HP Ground. I can Sky Drop the Gyarados. If it leads Coco, that's not a problem. Bulu is good in this because it deals with Gyarados as well as Porygon and Mudsdale. And I actually like, I think Hariyama helps out as well with me setting up and gives me fake out control, knock off for Celesteela, fake out for everything else. We're going to go with that. We're going to go Hariyama in the back next to Bulu, and we'll lead Dragonite with Zerkatry. What I'll actually do is probably Sky Drop the Gyarados and then Tail Glow up with Zerkatry. And then that'll allow me to HP ground the Marowak. And because if he leads Coco plus Gyarados, it's not too threatening for me, since Zerkatry doesn't really care about that, and my Dragonite is Assault Vest, and it will have the multi-scale intact. So hopefully plus 3 HP ground will be enough to knock out the Marowak. Actually, run a calc real quick. I might as well, considering I have it right here. Let me see. Zerkatry. I started with a Z. No. Custom set. Never mind. So he leads Mudsdale plus Gyarados. Like, I would still, if I'm discharged, he doesn't like this, but I don't deal with Mudsdale super, super well. I think my best bet is, it's also shiny Gyarados, so that means it could be Flying Z, I'm pretty sure. I think the best bet is to Sky Drop Gyarados, because if a Dragonite is up, my Bulu will come in after, and then just go directly into Bulu, and I'll just, Grassium directly into Gyarados. He might go Marowak right here, but that'll be okay. I could always bring out Hariyama and fake it out. And HP ground. Like, I see Mudsdale pulling back, but I'm not sure if he actually would, just because of the fact that Gyarados could also protect here. So, yeah, just high horsepower to me. Now again, this is a little bit odd. I'm pretty sure that the Mudsdale slot is either going to protect or go directly into Marowak. That's what I'd do, right? Bulldoze's power is weakened. If it is bounce, Mudsdale should go directly into... I'm going to Sky Drop Gyarados again. And I'm just going to go for SD. I'm going to expect him just not to be flying, even though he's shiny. So he could be bounce. I'm going to SD up. If he is that, then he doesn't threaten Gyarados. And then my Zerkatry in the back could put in a little bit of work with Hariyama. But Mudsdale should switch out into Marowak if he has it. Celesteela works too. If I Sky Drop Gyarados, I'm not as worried about it too. Yeah, he just Dragon Dances. So Gyarados is dead next turn. because I will have my SD. He's in the air, and when he comes down, I can just go for the Horn Leech. Wait, Gyarados too heavy to be lifted? Oh, I didn't know that. So that's my bad. I didn't know that Gyarados was too heavy to be lifted, fortunately. I wasn't aware that Gyarados is one of the heavier mons. See, this is something I'm learning from. I already made a mistake as we started. Let's bounce back, though. Waterium. I feel like if he doesn't have. Gonna make the Dragonite into Zerktree play. I'm gonna protect with my Bula. I feel like if he doesn't have Ice Fang or anything, he's gonna go for Protect with Gyarados just so he can heavy slam my Bulu. So I'm gonna go for that. I'll make the Zerktree play, get that thing in. And then I can protect with Zerktree in the following turn. Ideally, he doesn't have, again, he's just Ice Fang Waterfall. Yeah, he does protect. So that's fine. Like, he was trying to get rid of my Bulu this turn. So we can bounce back. Like I said, I never knew that Skydrop. I knew Skydrop wouldn't pick up certain heavy mons because they're naturally look heavy, but I didn't know Gyarados was one of them. It is a giant water snake, though. All right, so I should be able to knock out Gyarados right now. I'll protect my Zerktree just to be safe because Gyarados can't. Gyarados will probably attack in the Zerktree and Horn Leech at plus two. Yeah, this will easily be able to knock out Gyarados. I'll go for plus two Horn Leech. Just grass terrain boosted. Again, ideally he's not flying him. I think he's gonna Hydro Vortex into my Zerktree, which is why I'm gonna protect it, because that's why he stayed in with Celesteela. Let's see if that's a Hydro Vortex. I don't know if that's fly him or that looks watery. That does look watery. That boy is like watering around. That was a little bit of wave. That was kind of wavy. Yeah, so that's definitely going to Zerktree. And I can just Horn Leech the Gyarados and get rid of it. So we're not all the way in the back just yet. I'm pretty sure also Bulu at full HP does not die to Celesteela. Ever. And I didn't want to go for my Z because if he does have Marowak in the back, plus two Bloom Doom will be able to knock it out. So Gyarados is gone. Nice. Back at full, I won't go down. Can't leech see me. Heavy Slam won't kill me. Heavy Slam should not kill Bulu. This is top of Bulu. That is Tapu Bulu. All right, so I'll take it. Let's get a little bit of recovery on my boy Zerktree too. So if he has Marowak, he's bringing that out now. Like I'd bring out Marowak here always. If it's Mudsdale, then I just get to Thunderbolt. Okay, so I just Thunderbolt Zerktree and I Bloom Doom into Mudsdale. Because even if it protects, it's gonna hit him hard. Actually, why not Tail Glow just in case Marowak is in the back? And I'm a Bloom Doom, even if Mudsdale protects, I'm good. And I'll Tail Glow just to make Zerktree an actual threat, just in case whatever his back Pokemon is. Because I'm okay with losing Bulu right here. Doubles in, yeah, and it's Marowak. Nice. So this will die. This also covered that play. This will definitely die. This is plus two Bloom Doom. That's why we didn't attack you. And this should definitely be able to knock out Marowak, but I do struggle with Mudsdale. I'm not gonna lie, I do struggle with Mudsdale, so I'm gonna have to get some protect plays right. But Dragonite's Ice Beam does do about 40%. Also, grassy terrain is ending, so Mudsdale won't be recovering. This should easily kill. Plus two, grass terrain boosted. Wood Hammer, Bloom Doom. That boy was trying to bluff. Nah, but we are now a plus three Zerktree. Heavy slam. I thought it attacked Zerktree for a second. But okay, so we're plus D Zerktree. We definitely threaten. What beast boost is that? Defense as well. So this should be. Next turn should be the last turn of grass terrain. Oh, this is the last turn. Okay, good. I was right. Alright, so I'm gonna go Dragonite here. I think Dragonite's just best bet because Ice Beam does do 40%. And I'm pretty sure plus three. I don't want to lose this one, but I'm pretty sure plus three Zerktree with HP ground plus Ice Beam should be able to knock out Mudsdale. Though if it is. Yeah, he already uses Z move too, so he can't attack Zerg Tree. Yeah, he can't attack Zerg Tree, so my best play is just to protect right here. I was thinking about Tectonic Rage through protect, but he can't. He already uses Z move. So we Ice Beam into the Mudsdale, and we protect with Zerg Tree, burning out Celesteela's protect. And even if Celesteela does not protect, next turn I HP ground plus Ice Beam again, and we get rid of Mudsdale there. And then I can just safely Thunderbolt Celesteela, which cannot deal with me. So if we don't see Celesteela protecting, if he made the call to not protect this turn, yeah, good play. Doesn't matter though. This is gonna do about 40. I get a freeze, man. I swear I always freeze Mudsdale. I swear I always freeze Mudsdale. But I thought immediately though. So that's alright. Now, you would protect Celesteela now here, right? But if plus 3 HP ground doesn't knock it out, I'm not risking that. I'm going directly into Hariyama. Screw it. Like, I'm not risking plus 3 HP ground not knocking him out. Like, it doesn't matter how boosted Celesteela is. As long as I get rid of Mudsdale, we're good. And I don't want him protecting with Celesteela. That is the only thing I'm fearing. He should protect. Yep. So we burn that thing out. Dragonite doing another 30-40%. Nice stamina. No berry. High horsepower directly into Hariyama. Tanks it. Yeah, like I said, it doesn't matter how much Celesteela tanks as long as I beat Mudsdale. Just fake out Mudsdale and Ice Beam. Even if Mudsdale protects here. I'm thinking that might be a Salt Vest though, because it's actually only taking 30. It's only taking 30. Like, typically I do like 40% to Mudsdale. Raise that boy's stamina. That should still be out of barrier range too if he has it. This should also be able to KO him. Nice, so we get rid of Mudsdale there while not risking Zerg Tree. Now, I did mess up early on in the game, but, you know, it was all in the name of love. All to learn. It was just all to learn, and I think that's good. You know, I'm learning from it, and what we'll actually do is just switch out Dragonite because I don't want to get any Heavy Slam, and I can always knock off the Celesteela with my Hariyama and then just start tossing some CCs. You get an Earthquake here, if anything. So we'll knock out Celesteela. We'll switch out Dragonite because I don't want that Leech Seed. And then I'll just be able to Thunderbolt plus... I mean, I have Dragonite to Flamethrower as well. But as long as Celesteela loses potential recovery, we're good. So I'm glad we were able to bring this back. Like, I knew we could. It's not going to do crap to Hariyama. I did a decent chunk. I'm not going to lie. It's not bad damage. Not bad damage. Get rid of that boy's leftovers. And we'll go Dragon. We'll go Dragonite because I'm tired of him recovering. And just start spamming Thunderbolt. And I'm just happy we were able to bring that back. And I'm just switching around because I'm trying to ensure a victory. It got defense raised, not a special defense raise, so we're good. Give me some damage. That's a young Zerkatry, almost KO'd, and that's like 52 special attack investment, I want to say. So it's nothing right now. And we can just go for Flamethrower on Celesteela. That's the second Mudsdale that I've frozen, by the way, this week, with Dragonite's Ice Beam. And when I was using the team a little bit on Showdown. That is the game. Yeah, forfeits. I mean, I probably would have done the same. Saves me the animation time and whatnot. But, alright, so glad we were able to win that one. Bringing it back from a pretty poor start. But like I said, we learned. We now know that Gyarados cannot be picked up by Skydrop. I wish it could tell me when I clicked on it that Gyarados can't be picked up. That'd be nice. How am I supposed to memorize this guy's weight? Nah, we good. But that's also why, like I said, I bloomed him into a Mudsdale. If it protected, I'm pretty sure it died anyway. It's plus 2, grassy terrain. And if he went Marowak, I still killed that. Continue battling. Let's look for some more music to Totem Pokemon, Island Kahuna. Oh, we got one right away versus Mudkip. Alright. Not the starter I picked, but Metagross, Goodra, Arcanine. Metagross means probably Bulldoze stuff going on. That'd be interesting. How do I deal with that? I think I combat that with Tailwind from Murkrow. I actually like Murkrow Zerkatry a lot. Could Tail Glow up there. In the back, Dragonite, because it deals with Garchomp. And Metagross probably better than Bulu, I think. Because Metagross can deal with Feeny. Oh, so can Bulu. But Bulu's literally useless versus Sapsip or Goodra, though. So I think I'll go Metagross. We're going to try Murkrow lead. I don't think I've used Murkrow. I think I've only used Murkrow once. But the main reason I like Murkrow is because I can Tail Glow up and Tailwind immediately. If he leads Arcanine as a lead, it's okay. And if he leads Metagross, I can always just Foul Play directly into it. It won't die immediately. And I also have Quash. It won't die immediately, but this gives me just the option of Tailwind, which I like to see. I like when I see Metagross, Arcanine. And having Quash, having Taunt and whatnot. And Zerkatry pairs well next to Murkrow because it deals a lot with what Murkrow doesn't like. Tapu Fini, Tapu Koko. Likewise, Murkrow is a ground immunity for Zerkatry. And having Dragonite in the back means that Garchomp isn't as much of a threat. Assault Vest, his own Mystic Terrain if he has a random Dragon Claw. Typically, Rock Slide would be Garchomp's best way of dealing with me, though. Pokemon Trainer Mudkip. Let's see how these boys go. Lil Hat, I choose you. Arcanine, Coco. So I think I just Tailwind and... I Tail Glow and I Tailwind. I was just forgetting the word. Because I take Flare Blitz from Arcanine. Tailwind. I Tail Glow up. This just means if he goes directly into something like, let's say, Metagross coming in. Like, he'd Volt Switch into Metagross, if anything. But I still got my Tailwind up. And Arcanine will go down as well. Same thing with Metagross. And plus, I can bring in Dragonite next turn to deal with Arcanine. Like, I'm willing to sack Murkrow immediately just to get that Tail Glow up on Zerkatry. I really think that Metagross is in the back. Garchomp? That's fine. So, ideally, you knock out Murkrow here. And this gives me Dragonite. And Dragonite plus... Dragonite next to Zerkatry is amazing, especially under the Tailwind. Because I can Ice Beam that Garchomp and just Hidden Power Ground directly into Coco. I can actually Thunderbolt directly into Coco, too. Yeah. I'm going to Thunderbolt into Coco. It's plus 3 in the Lex terrain. Unless it's AV Coco, it dies. So we'll Ice Beam Garchomp. And Thunderbolt into Coco. Electrain boosted, plus 3, should be able to knock it out. And unless it's Sash Garchomp, it should also go down to Dragonite. AV Garchomp, though, would be an issue, but then you have to protect Coco, and then I get nothing out of this turn. That'd be really bad for me. But then I have Metagross under... I still have Metagross, though, so... And I can still Bulldoze in the following turn, and still deal with his team, and get my plus 2 Metagross, so that'd be good. So I think, even if this turn goes absolutely poorly, I'd still get a plus 2 Metagross somehow. Thank you for the Electric Terrain! I appreciate you. Let's see. Die. Nice. Garchomp gone. This is why I love this. And this should be able to knock out. I mean, I'm not max attack investment, but it's plus 3 Electric Terrain boosted. So that means that whatever's coming in, probably be Arcanine plus Metagross. I see that. But it doesn't matter because we are plus 4 Coco in Electric Terrain and a multi-scale Dragonite. So this should be game. This should be game. Look at Zerkatry just dancing. Hey. Yep, Metagross Arcanine. What I figured. Arcanine cannot knock out my Zerkatree with Flare Blitz ever, unless it's Choice Band. You know, I mean, Choice Band, I think, doesn't Oko on full. Actually, Choice Band is the only one that Oko. But it's just a safe, because my Dragonite is always faster than my Zerkatree, it's just a safe Sky Drop into Arcanine and a Thunderbolt into Metagross. No Protects. Yeah, this one will be able to knock out Metagross, and then next turn when Arcanine comes back down, I knock it out. So just a nice Zerkatree sweep. Beautiful. Good B! Go ahead and give me another Beast Boost. Zerkatree actually just Beast Boosting out here. And now we just Thunderbolt directly into Arcanine as it comes down. So this is like... I couldn't have asked for better plays. I couldn't have asked for a better game. This is how the team functions when typically with Murkrow. Dragonite next to something is usually a free setup or a free attack. As you see, Dragonite's EVTB out to out to be Zerkatree. So I'm glad I was able to at least show how the team goes in this final game here. Really happy about that. And happy that we were able to pick up a really quick W. Love Dragonite in the meta. I think it's so cool. AV is really nice because of, you know, people don't expect Ice Beam and whatnot. Being able to pick up that KO on Garchomp is really nice. And then just letting Zerkatree put in some work. So, like I said, glad we were able to get a win there. I think we pretty much showed off how it was supposed to be. Tail going up immediately made the most sense to me. Just because, again, this Zerkatree is bold. Or it's, yeah, it is bold. It's bold. It has the Fat Berry. And just getting up that Tailwind and pretty much being able to ensure that some kills, I got them. Great. So, yeah, happy. Very happy with that. Hope you guys all enjoyed, of course. Feel free to leave a like, subscribe. We'll be moving on to another team tomorrow. Like I said, leave that like if you did enjoy. And shout out to my boy Abe for the team. Hope I did a little bit of justice, at least in this episode. I hope I did it just a little bit of justice in this episode. But I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye, friends.